hats, our shoes were our showboats. We kicked around from stairway to station. We made a sensation with the gadabout crowd. And oh, what a bargain, we're two easy targets for the old man at the off tracks, who paid in palaver and crumpled old dollars, which we squirreled away in our rat trap hotel by the freeway. And we slept in Sunday. Your parents were anxious, your cool was contagious at the old school. You left without leaving a note for your grieving sweet mother, while your brother was so cruel. And here in
the alley. Thanks for the ride.
There you go. Where do you live?
Just head down North Street. I live on the other side of town.
So how long have you lived here?
My family moved here when I was like 7 or 8, so pretty much as long as I can remember. How about you?
My whole life. Born and raised.
Cool.
Yeah, it's cool, I guess. I'm just ready to graduate. I can't wait to get out of here. What?
It's alright. It just seems to be everyone's theme around here, wanting to leave. Everyone seems to hate it here.
You don't?
No. I like it. I've never seen what's so bad about it. Why does everyone want to leave so bad?
I don't know. I want to go somewhere where I can see something else, experience more in life. I don't want to die having known only this town. I mean, you said you've lived here as long as you can remember. You don't want to die knowing only this town, do you?
I don't know, I guess not. Do you really think you'll remember everything when you die?
I hope so.
Me too. I actually hope that when I die, I get to stay on Earth as a ghost. Really? I think it'll be awesome. My grandparents always used to take me to church when I was a kid. And of course, for a while, I completely believed everything they told me. And I knew that one day I'd die and I'd either go to heaven or hell. And if I went to hell, then I'd burn and be tortured for all eternity. And that whole thing. And if I went to heaven, then I'd walk on streets of gold and worship God all the time. But I never could help but think that even with heaven, I'd miss all the stuff I'd grown to love in life. Sounds silly, but I'm afraid of one day realising that I'll never be able to watch one of my favourite movies again, or read one of my favourite books, or hear some of my favourite songs. If I came back as a ghost, then I could go anywhere I liked. And no one could see me, or hear me, or bother me. And I could have all the things I have here. You know, assuming I could touch things and control things the way I can now.
What about people? I think I'd miss people even if I had all of that. But you can't talk to anybody. And even worse, you can't touch anybody. Whatever happens, I want people to be there. I want human interaction. I want people to be there so I can have friends and get to know someone. I want to be able to go out on a date with a girl. Go swimming with a group of friends in the middle of the night.
Do you think it's too much to hope that when we die we get to go somewhere where we just get to hang out all the time with people we know and love, and we can have everything we have here and we just get to hang out forever?
And everything's free there and nobody has to work or anything, and we can just relax and hang out. like an eternal vacation. With everyone. And everything you know. I think it'd be great if it ended up that way.
Maybe whatever you believe when you die is what you end up getting. You know, like, if you believe in heaven, then that's what you'll get. If you believe in nothing, then you'll get nothing. If we believe in this, then maybe we'll get it.
I hope you're right.
But is it silly to hope for something like that? I mean, I used to believe in God, but as I've gotten older, I've started to think that the whole heaven afterlife thing is just something to comfort people who are afraid of dying. People who are afraid of not existing anymore.
Well, that's what we're talking about, isn't it? Being afraid of not existing?
Yeah, it is. And yeah, I'm afraid of that. I can't pretend I'm not. But part of me can't help but think that I'm wasting my time on those thoughts. Part of me thinks that this whole conversation's a waste of time because one day there'll be nothing. I won't have any thoughts. I won't miss anything or anyone because I won't be anything or anyone. Sorry, didn't mean to be a downer there.
That's fine. But you know, I don't think that this conversation is a waste of time. I mean, yeah, it doesn't affect anything, but I think that just talking about it helps now. And if we really don't have anything to look forward to after death, then now is really what matters, you know? Times like these that we shouldn't take for granted or waste. But driving in a car in the middle of the night, it's not something that I would ever consider to be a waste of time. I mean, if I were gonna die tomorrow, I'd be happy with the way I spent my last night. I'd be happy I was here. Yeah, that probably sounds pretty lame, but it's true.
You know, the part of me that said that this whole thing's a waste of time isn't very smart.
Okay, so I have an idea. Inspired by something that you said earlier. I think it'll be interesting.
Okay.
Pretend that you knew you were going to die tomorrow, and right now is the only chance that you have to listen to one song. What would it be?
That's not hard at all.
I know, but you have to pick one. And better yet, if you can, don't tell me what it is. Just play it.
Okay, got it.